And like, we're going to talk about all these things that cause us to be, amen, miss our blessing. Now, it's definitely to miss your blessing, because the Bible says he that goeth forth what weepeth and bearing what precious seed shall doubtless come again with what rejoicing. Woo! How many more rejoicing? I mean, it don't take long for you to get pumped up when you begin to what? Go forth reaping and what? Going forth what? Bearing precious seed. That means many things. See how you can help them. Amen. It might be some of those that you probably got 10,000 scriptures in your possession. Amen. You think they deserve to have more? Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. This is the secret of what? Blessings. This is the secret of a full life. Jesus said, I'm come that you might have what? Life. And to have life what? More abundantly. Amen. You know, there's a way that you can get a release from drawback spirits and fear, because God has not given us a spirit of fear, but he has given us a spirit of what? Power. What? Love. And a what? Sound mind. And all of those components that we need, amen, are already within us. And we just got to find a way. Amen. And I got the solution today for how you can turn a timid, weak-kneed, angelic-backed, average believer, hallelujah, amen, into a person of great strength and boldness. Amen. Jesus loves people. Why were people so attracted to Jesus? Why were immoral women? Oh, man, who was that? Mary Magdalene, is that right? She was what? A harlot. But she was attracted to Jesus. Why were the biggest crook in town, Zacchaeus? Why was he attracted to Jesus? All right, the Bible said, when Jesus talked to them, they felt something in his voice. Oh, his countenance was so pleasant. His words were words of what? Compassion. Oh, he had respect for them. He didn't do like the Levite and the who? Publican. But the Levite and the who? Priest, right. There you go. He didn't do like the preacher and the teacher. Jesus was what? Moved with compassion. When they came into Jesus' presence, boy, they were just so comfortable, because they knew that Jesus would respect them. He would have compassion. He wouldn't try to what? He wouldn't try to what? Down them, or just show disrespect for them and talk about how rotten and how terrible and how big a sinners they were. These were certified sinners, big time sinners. But they loved Jesus. Oh, gee, how many believe that we can show the same compassion, the same love, amen, just by following, just do what Jesus did? How God anointed Jesus with the Holy Ghost and with what? Power. Woo, glory. Who went about what? Doing good, healing all of those that were what? Oppressed by the devil. Amen. We ought to be concerned about people that's oppressed by the devil. How many can say amen? Amen? Amen. So that's the thing that we want to understand. Whatever Jesus did in order to have the disposition that he had, that he could attract people, that he was bold. Amen. Praise God. That he was full of what? Eager yearning. In other words, when he saw people that were in distress, it just broke his heart. Bible says when the leper came to Jesus that was full of leprosy, and nobody wanted no part of it, a leper, because they had to be isolated from everybody. They had to be separated completely from society. Hallelujah. But when Jesus heard the leper, he said, Jesus, hallelujah, have mercy on me. I want to be clean. I want to be healed of my leprosy. The Bible says when Jesus saw the leper, he stretched forth his hands And he laid his hand on the leper and said, what? Be thou clean. Yes. Bible says the leper, leprosy just what? Vanished. Amen. Jesus was moved with compassion. You can just go, amen, when he was confronted with a multitude that were hungry, the Bible says Jesus was moved with compassion. Amen. So the secret to Jesus' ministry was that he had to, amen, at all times, he had to stay very closely connected for all of this compassion, for all of this anointing, for all of this strength, for all of this, hallelujah, anointing to flow through him. He had to stay very closely connected to his what? Heavenly Father. Amen. If you're hooked up right, how many want to be hooked up right? Hey, Lord, hallelujah, hallelujah. If you're hooked up right, amen, that love is going to what? It's going to flow. It's going to what? Move you. You're going to let your little puny feelings say, well, I don't believe I can. If I want to say something, but I don't know whether it'll come out right. People don't care about what comes out as long as you move with compassion. Is that right? When they see tears, when they see compassion, when they can see a deep yearning that your heart is what? Glory is in tune with the need. If they see that their problems, you are touched by the problems, that you sincerely have a desire to what? To, amen, to eliminate whatever the source of that problem is. Amen. When they see that, words are not that important. Whether you got these big, amen, Sunday school words or not, it's not that important. But the secret to Jesus' success is that his oneness, amen, his what? Fellowship. Woo, glory to God. His constant communion. His constant communion with his what? Heavenly Father. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And that's the reason why Jesus' secret was what? Prayer. He placed more emphasis on prayer than he did on teaching. Because without prayer, amen, even though you might connect with people, you don't have a clue as to how to help them. It takes what? Prayer. It takes what? Hearing from God. It takes being what? Led by God. It takes being what? Stirred and motivated and strengthened by God in order to be in a position where you can really what? Help people and really get at the bottom of meeting their needs. Hallelujah. How many can say amen? Amen. Amen. So I believe that the secret has always been, amen, praise God, prayer, 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 prayer. Prayer and the word. How many can say amen? He takes the word, but it takes what? Prayer. The word is watered by what? Prayer. How many can say amen? The word is the thing that what? Makes prayer what? Effective. Hallelujah. Amen. And prayer is the thing that makes the word what? Effective. How many can say amen? So that's the answer, amen, to following the example of Jesus. We have to start following the examples, the same examples that Jesus gave us. Amen. I read these last week, and I want to encourage you again to read, amen, the book, Following the Example of Jesus. Amen. Wednesday night, we're going to be focusing on this again. Scripture says, he went up into a mountain apart to pray, and when evening was come, he was there alone. In the morning, rising up a great while before day. How many know we start morning prayer tomorrow morning? That means you have to rise up a great while before day. To pray, somebody said, you better rise up a great while before day if you want to hear from God. Because most times you get so busy, even if you want to walk, most times you have to do it what? First thing in the morning, early. Make it priority, right? If you put it off, that's how good 11 o'clock. Wait till it gets a little warmer. It's cold, too cold to walk now. I walk at 2. What happens at 2? Something else happens, right? And most times you will never get around to what? To doing it if you just what? If you just keep putting it off. In the morning, if you really want to have a different results this year, amen, I want to encourage you to get yourself stirred up, not just for the sake of praying, but for the sake of being able to what? To show mercy. Every believer, you got to come up with something that helps you to release your what? Release your what? Your spirit. Amen. And to build you up and to draw in that grace that God is going to what? Release as you begin to what? Go forth weeping and bearing precious seed. Bible says you're going to come again with what? Rejoicing. Amen. Touch somebody and say, we got to get up early. Amen. If you don't come out to 844 East 46th Street North, I want you to get up. Amen. Get up. Amen. Praise God. Get up. Turn somebody and say, you have to get up. So I said, well, I watch TV until 1 o'clock. I can't get up until 5. Boy, we're so full of this TV stuff, man. Sometimes, praise God, when we come to church, we're out in a foreign place. Hallelujah. But if you really want, the anointing on your life is going to require, amen, some sacrifices. We're going to have to follow. The Bible says, Jesus, what? He went through a whole lot of suffering. He did a whole lot of things that he didn't want to do. Amen. He denied himself. He could have said, well, I'm going to sleep until 10 o'clock. Amen. Like all the other preachers. Why do I have to get up? You know, sometimes, Pastor Hill, I say, why do I have to go through all these changes? I mean, Pastor down here, Pastor Doolittle or Shepherd, whoever he's down here, amen, he don't have to do all this stuff that I have to do. Get up and pray. Amen. Right before day. Try to, amen, push people to read the Bible and to read their what? Bible study notes and things of that nature that will enrich them. Amen. Go through all of these changes and amen. Try to help people. Why do I have to do all of that? Because the scripture said, if any man comes after me, he has to what? Deny himself and what? Take up his cross and what? Follow me. He that seeketh to save his life will what? Lose it. But he that what? Loseth his life for my sake shall what? Right. So your answer this year is going to be in what? Making that sacrifice. Following Jesus. Getting out of your comfort zone and really offering up your life and not, amen, praise God, not living your life just unto yourself. The Bible says he that seeketh to save his life shall what? Lose it. There's no way that joy and that abundance of grace can be released in your life unless we place ourselves in the position where God's grace can what? Can reach us. And that is the place. If I had to say just one area that you have to place yourself in order for God's grace to reach you, I would say it's in the area of mercy. Showing mercy. Everybody say, showing mercy. Hallelujah. We can come and pray from now on, but we got to what? Take this anointing. Take this what? Anointing. This what? The word, whatever we receive when we come here, we got to take that out and begin to what? Bless people with it. Amen. Sharing the scripture. I think that women, amen, and men, I think that we need to what? Do like Jesus, go about doing good. Might be going into homes. That's the way we started this ministry. We started going into homes and sharing with people until we got a breakthrough with them in Bible lessons and in prayer. Then we were what? We were actually reaping some really, amen, praise God, powerful harvest. Amen. I like to see the living room going into homes. Amen. Some say, well, modern, we got all this modern technology. Nobody do that no more. I can do everything I want to do. I can just send them an email. Amen. You can send them an email, but sometimes you're going to have to what? Amen. They're going to have to what? See your compassion.
Amen. They want some hands laid on them every once in a while. Is that right? They want to say, amen, praise God, brother. You can make it. I love you. Amen. It means something. I can just, amen. Hallelujah. So this year is going to be a year that we need to get equipped. Amen. To get off of these pews. Amen. I want you here on Wednesday night. Here on Monday night. Whenever you can make it. Amen. This is going to be prayer week. But we want to come and receive. Amen. My life was completely changed the month of September. Amen. I'm ready to go out in revivals right now. Amen. My brother called me yesterday. He said, aren't you back out in revivals yet? I know he was right trying to, amen, see if I would come down and just, amen, do revivals in, at his two churches. Amen. I said, well, I'm praying with Northside now. I'm going to see what they're going to do. If they don't do nothing. Glory. So this is going to be a week that we need to what? Wake up. If you want more mercy, you're going to have to what? How many believe we can show more mercy? How many believe that all of us got some type of ministry?
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I want everybody here today. Amen. I want you to come. I want you to stand up on your feet right now. I'm just going to, amen, turn this week over to the Lord.